In 1995, two Stanford computer science graduates, Page and Brin, collaborated in a research project into web blackening analysis. The project resulted in a company that changed the internet, Google.
Welcome everyone, and we'll start with a brief history of Google. The name Google is a play on words of Google, which is a mathematical term for number 1, followed by 100 zeros. It is said this reflects the founder mission to organize infinite amount of information on the internet.
In 1995, Page and Brin met at Stanford University while they were graduated students in computer science. Later, the pair began writing the program for search engine dubbed Backrub. It is named after its ability to do a blackening analysis. The outcome is summarized in a widely titled research paper, The Anatomy of Large-Scale Hypertextual to Web Search Engine. The search engine was unique, and later they developed PageRank, which developed the website relevance by taking into account the number of pages along with importance of pages that linked back to original site. After this analysis, they began working on developing Google. Operating in their own rooms, the pair built a server network using cheap computers.
This was the first of Google launch in 1996, which was released on Stanford website. Originally, the search engine used Stanford website with the domain google.stanford.edu. The domain google.com was registered a year later. On June 7, 1999, a round of equity funding total $25 million was announced. Google still needed more funding at that point. The Google search engine attracted a loyal following among growing number of internet users who were in love with its simple design. In 2000, Google began selling advertisements associated with search keyword. It was based on a combination of price bid and click-through with bidding starting at 5 cents per click.
Google then announced an IPO to raise as much as $4 billion. After quickly outgrowing the company, listed a complex of building in Mountain View. Google acquired Android in 2005 with $90 million. This was the best deal ever for them.
Google, with its parent company Alphabet Incorporated, is involved in every aspect of our life.
In this part of the video, we'll discuss some of the major Google products. Android TV for television, Android Auto for cars, and Wear OS for wristwatches, each with a special interface. We'll now directly watch how exactly Android Auto works by watching a video launched by Google.
You know that car you drive every day? The one you think you know inside out? Turns out that car may have some hidden talents. Hidden talents that could change how you drive. Chances are your car is compatible with Android Auto, because almost 100 million vehicles are. Which means your car isn't just a car, it's a command center. Your Android device integrates seamlessly with your car's display, so you can drive more safely and access the power of your Android device. You can talk to Google to send messages, make calls, play your favorite tunes, books, and podcasts. Even find ways to avoid traffic on your way to that secret spot your Android device helped you find. Maybe the best part, Android Auto is ready to roll. And that car of yours is ready to start bringing its hidden talents out into the open for you.
This was the complete video on how Android Auto exactly works.
During the period of rapid growth, company introduced a variety of products including Gmail, Google Docs, Google Drive, web browser Chrome, a smart speaker Google Home, broadband Google, F, self-driving cars. It also acquired streaming video platform YouTube, smart home product Nest, and blogger.com. These are rest of the Google products.
As we are scrolling down, you can see there are so many Google products. Some are for all, some are for business, and some are for developers. Basically, we can say that Google has covered it all for all of us. In 2015, Google underwent a restructure of division. As of 2021, there are around 1,39,995 employees. Sergey Brin became the president and Larry Page became the CEO. Currently, this position is filled by Sundar Pichai. Google is the most powerful and popular search engine in the world. Currently, it has 40,000 search queries per second and 3.5 billion searches per day and 1.2 trillion searches per year. Google generates their major revenues from advertisements. Google launched a project Aristotle, which was a huge data study focused on teamwork. The tech giant spent millions of dollars tracking 180 separate teams for 3 years. The goal of the project was simple yet ambitious: to find out what are the traits of highest performing teams. In other words, all they wanted to know that why some teams stumble while others sort out.
They thought maybe the best teams had members who liked each other a lot, or there was a healthy mix of personality types. But there was no evidence that mix of personality types is the reason, so this equation didn't seem to matter. As the researchers continued, they noticed two main behaviors that the best team shared. First, equality in distribution of conversational turn-taking. On some teams, everyone spoke equally in each matter, while on some other, leadership shifted among teammates from assignment to assignment. In other words, as long as everyone got a chance to talk, the team did well. But if only person did the work or spoke all the time, the collective intelligence declined. Second, high average social sensitivity. They were skilled at reading how others felt based on the tone of voice, expressions, and other non-verbal cues. One of the easiest way to determine social sensitivity is to show someone photos of a person's eye and ask them to describe what that person is feeling. It is known as reading the mind in the eyes.
People on successful teams scored above average. They seemed to know when someone was feeling upset or left out. On the contrast, people on less effective teams scored below average. They were less sensitive towards their colleagues and co-workers. Researchers came to conclusion with 3 points. The first one was, it didn't matter who was on the team. What mattered was how they treated each other, where everybody talked and everybody showed respect. And the third one was whether they created psychological safety of each member in the group. Creating a positive impact on the team so that they can succeed together. Let's now discuss the Google CSR, Company Social Responsibility. Some of the few CSR activity implemented by Google are: first, education and learning; second, joblessness and poverty; third, use of renewable energy. Learning and education are for the unprivileged and is one of the primary focus area in CSR strategy. They are devoting its technological resources to its best and are also providing scholarship to the student. Google is helping children around the world achieve their fullest potential through education and are also providing books and videos to those who don't have access to any. It has also been observed that it increases employee satisfaction, it helps them gain motivation and pride in their work, they feel respected and supported. Google also provides 100% healthcare coverage for employee and their family. Google also helps an individual to increase creativity by contributing to the bigger picture. They give you best of the opportunities and help you contribute new ideas about the product.
we'll talk about the challenge faced by Google in conducting their CSR program. The major challenge faced by Google in conducting their CSR program is using much cost. And the other one is need to compete with other brands. Amazon, Microsoft and Apple. It is not easy for them to compete with other companies that also has a brand value. The main problem which comes up as a challenge for Google in conducting out their CSR programs is using much cost. Google is technology business, thus it is profitable but it comes with a cost.
Now moving on from company social responsibility, we'll cover the turnover analysis by Google, that is the finance section of Google. This slide will show advertising revenue generated by Google in billion US dollar. You can look at the graph and see how periodically it is increasing till 2016. Also, the second picture shows the total revenue generated by Alphabet is $162 billion. This graph shows the revenue generated by Google advertising quarterly. For the calendar year 2022, Alphabet has reported a net income of $40,269 million. The annual revenue was $182.5 billion, an increase of 23% over the previous fiscal year.
As per its 2017 annual report, 86% of Alphabet's revenue came from performance advertising and brand advertising. 53% came from its international operations. This translated to a total revenue of Other than this, on February 1, 2016, Alphabet Incorporated surpassed Apple to become the world's most valuable publicly traded company until February 3, 2016, when Apple surged back over Alphabet to retake the position. Experts cited Apple's lack of innovation as well as increasing Chinese competition as reasons for this.
Now let's see how Google performed in the year 2019. As of 2019, Alphabet is ranked number 15 on the Fortune 500. On January 16, 2020, Alphabet became the fourth US company to reach a $1 trillion market.
Now let's talk about Google's major accomplishments.
Let's firstly cover the accomplishment by AdSense. This ad platform was launched in 2003 and opened up a whole new playing field for online advertising. AdSense now cover Google's 30% of the giant revenue. Moving on to YouTube and Android accomplishment.
Google acquired the video platform in 2006 for $1.65 billion. Today, the platform enjoys 3 billion ad impressions a week. Google acquired Android in 2005 and in 2007 announced it was the company's official smartphone platform.
This is the Google main team members till date: Sundar Pichai, Larry Page, Sergey Brin, Cesar Sengupta, Eve Anderson and Catherine Courage. Now let's hear from Sundar Pichai himself that what are his plans for future for Google.
I'm really excited to announce our next generation of TPUs, cloud TPUs, which are optimized for both training and inference. What you see behind me is one cloud TPU board. It has four chips in it, and each board is capable of 180 trillion floating point operations per second. We want Google Cloud to be the best cloud for machine learning. And so we want to provide our customers with a wide range of hardware, be it CPUs, GPUs, including the great GPUs NVIDIA announced last week, and now cloud TPUs.
Thank you so much, and here we end our presentation.